What have you done now? Why are you sitting down? If you're gonna be disrespectful, stand up.
Some guy was saying shit.
You threw the first punch. Are you stupid? You already know what this means. You're going to a new school.
But my head of year said if I improve, I can come back.
Improve? How long now have you had to improve? Do you two always have to be on your phones?
Well, what else is there to do?
What do you see me doing? I'm reading the Bible. Where was you last night?
The bus is late.
Always this late, yeah? Shay, go upstairs.
Why do I have to go upstairs?
Go upstairs. What's that smell?
Huh?
You know exactly what I mean.
I'm trying a new cologne.
Am I making you laugh, yeah?
Mum, honestly, I don't know what you're talking about.
Why can't you...
Why can't I what? Be like Shay? Isn't that what you always say?
Chris, you're 16. You've been to prison for possession already. Why can't you just fix up at school and at home?
What more can I do?
What do you mean?
What more can you do?
I work 3 jobs to keep a roof over your head. You still hanging with them idiots that I told you to stop hanging with?
They're not idiots.
They're idiots. They bunk school and smoke weed.
You'd rather I pretend everything's okay? All happy families and that.
I miss your dad too.
So then why are you talking about him?
Came from PE.
Well, get your stuff and go sit next to the next Chris.
Nah, I work with someone else.
You will sit next to Chris unless you want another session?
Go on then.
Bro, why didn't you want to sit next to him?
I just don't like the look of him.
and handing this over to you now, God. Why does your brother never come down here?
This week was so long. I have so much homework.
You should not leave it to the last minute. Don't make a habit of that.
I won't.
Bad habits cause trouble. You know that, Shay.
Have you seen the homework I get in maths? Everyone complains about it.
Chris, come here. How was your first day at school? Was it okay?
Yeah.
So come and tell me more. Do you want to come to church with me and your sister tomorrow?
Church?
Yeah.
Why?
Do you know what that picture shows?
Oh, no. I beg you. Please. No, lecture. You told me 1,000 times. Martin Luther King.
You see, my mum, she used to tell me a story about her mum, your great-grandmother. She lived on a plantation. She was a slave. She was bought and paid for. She was whipped when she underperformed, and she saved up enough money to bring us here. God rest her soul. You know, she showed me the value of hard work, Chris. That picture, it's not about non-violence. It's not even about a person. It's about a different way of living. To love each other and to pray.
My dad didn't pray.
And now he's in a grave. That's why we visit him every week.
Yo! Where's my money? Where's my money?
I told you.
Chris, what?
Well, Chris, yeah?
Yeah, what?
You have 5 seconds to leave a watch!
A watch!
Oh, you're awake? We've contacted your parents. They'll be on their way soon.
My leg's fucked.
No, it's not. It's just badly bruised. You will need a couple of weeks to heal, and then you'll need to learn how to practice walking again, just for the circulation. Are you going to help your friend?
Slowly.
You're right.
Yeah.
Watch out.
You're right. What happened with those boys?
It's nothing.
Do you know them?
They're just pricks.
Does school know?
What are they gonna do? You're new to the school. Why'd you find trouble for yourself?
I brought some guy's joy at my last school. He was spreading rumours about my sister.
I have sisters too, you know. Nothing like me though. Wouldn't know that thing. Not even after Dad died. She just moved on. He was a police officer, you know. I remember when they came to our door, drove us to the hospital. My dad, they showed us his killers. 3 black men, stabbed him 12 times.
I'm sorry, but we're not all the same.
I know. I'd just do anything to have another day with him.
Do you know where you're going?
Yeah, I do.
My dad died as well, from a drug overdose. But before that, he'd make it a thing to come spend time with me. Every Friday night, we'd watch TV and eat everything that was in the fridge. My mum would flip out. He drank a lot though, He was the funniest guy. He was a lightweight though.
My dad was a fussy eater. Always explained this so that he could be the best police officer if he had to chase someone. He once tried making healthy pasta, but burnt the pasta in the water. Like, how's that possible? He'd tell the same stories to guests every time. He knew it would get him laughs, bring people together. He knew that in those moments, we forget our vulnerability.